Dear viewers, welcome to our channel GVS Bank Academy. Today I am going to discuss about JAB, Principle and Practice of Banking Paper, some most important questions and answers for revision purpose, exclusively for revision purpose. Now, classification of assets, classification of loans and advances, and IRAC norms, income recognition and asset classification norms, introduced based on Narasimha Committee recommendation. So, classification of assets, substandard or doubtful loss, income recognition, asset classification norms based on Narasimha Committee recommendation. DPG, deferred payment guarantees or financial guarantees. DPG, deferred payment guarantees or financial guarantees. For supply of capital goods, the borrowers are directly purchasing the capital goods from the suppliers. For that, the supplier is asking the guarantee. For that, banks are giving guarantee. That is called financial guarantee. DPG, deferred payment guarantee, always treated as financial guarantees. What is the difference between term loan and DPG? In the term loan, initially, we are deploying funds. We are giving a loan. We are disbursing the loan. Whereas under DPG, deferred payment guarantee, we are giving an undertaking on behalf of the borrower in the form of guarantee. That is the only difference. Term loan, outlay of funds you are giving. DPG, you are giving an undertaking in the form of guarantee. That is the only difference. But processing of term loan DPG, just like TPG only, term loan only. Processing of DPG, deferred payment guarantee, just like term loan. Maximum period of bank guarantee, generally 10 years. If any bank want to issue bank guarantee beyond 10 years, there must be some board approved policy document must be there in that bank. Anything beyond 10 years. Normally up to 10 years banks are allowed. Anything beyond 10 years, it must be a board approved policy as for that bank. Safe custody of articles defined under Indian Contract Act. Safe custody. That if the customer, banker-customer relationship, bailer is the customer and bailee is the bank. Bailer, customer, bailee is the bank relationship. Bailee-bailer relationship is there between the customer and the bank in safe custody. Short-term solvency. Short-term solvency means current ratio, quick ratio or asset ratio will determine whether the unit, whether the firm is in therein to meet its obligations in the short run, that is normally up to 1 year. Short term solvency position, we can judge through current ratio or quick ratio or asset ratio. Long term solvency, we can judge the firm or company through debt equity ratio, debt equity ratio or DSC, debt service coverage ratio. This is called long term solvency. Bank guarantee, banks are issuing bank guarantee for contractors for due performance of their works. That is called as performance guarantee. Bank guarantee for contractors for due performance of their work, performance guarantee. As for PMLA, Prevention of Money Laundering Act, maintenance of records for a period of 5 years from the date of cessation, closure of the transaction. Even after closure of the transaction also, bank has to maintain documents 5 years as per PMLA, Prevention of Money Laundering. Registration of charge with Register of Companies under Section 77 of the Companies Act 2013. This is the duty of the company to create charge in favor of the bank from the date of loan within 30 days from the creation of charge with banks. So, from the date of loan documentation, within 30 days, the borrowing company had to register the charge in favor of the bank with the Register of Companies. That is called under Section 77. HEF, Hindu Undivided Family. HEF cannot be a partner in LLP, Limited Liability Partnership Firm, and Partnership Firm also. HEF cannot be a partner in Limited Liability and Partnership Firm. right of appropriation rule in Clayton's case. In Clayton's case means when the accounts are there in cash credit account, overdraft account, running ledger balances, particularly in the partnership firm cases, whenever any partner is expired, to crystallize the liability of the partner on that day, banks are going to stop the, banks must stop the operation in that account, running account, for deciding the liability of the deceased partner. That is the SEBI functions. The main functions to SEBI, to regulate securities market, capital market, to protect the interest to investors in security, protect the investors, interest of investor in security market, to promote the development of securities market. These are the SEBI, capital market regulatory SEBI. Regulate securities market, protect the interest of investor in the security market. This is the what is the maximum extent up to which a single investor can hold shares in Indian stock exchanges? So, when a single investor, how much he can hold shares in the paid-up capital means maximum 5% of paid-up capital. A single investor can hold shares in any Indian stock exchange. SFMS, Structured Financial Messaging System. As of today, all banks are following this. In NEFT transaction, RTGS transaction, any standing instructions. Not only banks, other organizations are also, you know, even insurance companies, they are following. Whenever any transaction is there, they are sending the messages to the customer through SFMS, Structured Financial Messaging System. This is just like a confirmation. Security receipts are issued by ARCs, Asset Reconstruction Companies to QIBs, qualified institutional buyers. At the time of sale of NP assets by banks to ARCs, part of the amount ARCs are paying cash to banks, remaining amount ARCs are issuing security receipts. Security receipts, that is asset reconstruction at the time of purchase of NP. What are the objectives of mergers? Diversification of activities, improved profitability. One is diversification. Second one is improved profitability by reducing the expenditure. Economy, improve economies of scale means large scale operations. So ultimately, mergers object to profitability, economies of scale, diversification of activities. Red herring prospectus. This is the prospectus issued by a company under big bullying process. The red herring process prospectus is issued by a company at the time of issuing shares to the public under book building electronic process to raise capital from market under book building, in which a price or number of shares is not disclosed in this prospectus. When a company is issuing red herring, in that prospectus, they cannot disclose either issuing price or number of shares issued. They cannot disclose that in the red herring prospect. Now, this is the internal integrated ombudsman scheme. Integrated ombudsman scheme. This is the initiative of RBI, recent initiative. Now, RBI is planning to integrate the ombudsman schemes of banking, NBFCs and digital transaction under the concept of, under the roof of one nation, one ombudsman. So, RBI is under process integration of ombudsman scheme of banking, NBFCs and digital transaction, one nation and one ombudsman. Members of credit information companies. Credit information, who are the members in credit information companies? Credit institution means financial institutions, insurance companies, companies providing telephone services, credit rating companies, asset reconstruction companies. All these are all the members in the credit information companies. They can use the information from credit information companies. What are the advantages of leasing? Advantage of leasing. Leasing may be low-cost alternative. Sometimes, when compared to other type of finances, leasing may be low-cost. Now, leasing is preserving the borrowing capacity of the borrower. Leasing transactions are preserving the borrowing capacity of the borrower. And it is also capital conservation. Normally, sometimes leasing companies are providing 100% financing under lease. So, from borrower, he need not pay any margin also to the leasing company. So, because of these transactions, ultimately, this is advantages of leasing. One is low cost. It is preserving the borrowing capacity of the borrower in the case of emergency. 100% finance they are getting. That is leasing. Securitization of financial assets. Securitization means sale off. Why banks or non-banking companies, they are selling assets or loans, recycling of funds. Securitization means sale of NPA to other banks or financial institutions. Sale of NPA, so that securitization means conversion of illiquid assets into liquid assets. Securitization means conversion of illiquid assets into liquid assets. Or what is the object to recycling of funds? What are the funds blocked in the NPA? And by selling, they are getting back. And again, they are putting into use. That is called recycling of funds. Process of segregation of ownership in stock exchanges. Process of segregation of ownership in stock exchanges. Ownership and trading rights of the members in a stock exchange is called demutualization. Demutualization means the ownership and the trading rights, they are segregation through demutualization. Means, you see, NSE, National Stock Exchange, BSE also, through demutualization, they had separated the ownership and trading rights, and both the NSE, BSE has converted into companies under Companies Act 2013. This is the process of segregation of ownership and trading rights. Transparency and better working, better monitoring, better control. Now, this is happened. Demutualization is happened. This is there. DEF, Depositors Education and Awareness Fund, that is introduced under Banking Regulation Act, Section 26A. Unclaimed deposits more than 10 years. Inoperative deposits more than 10 years. As for this DEF, all banks have to transfer to RBI within 3 months from the date of expiry of 10 years. Now, on that, as per latest circular, banks are getting rate of interest 3%. Presently, on the unclaimed deposits transferred to RBI, banks are getting rate of interest 3%. White label ATM. Means ATM installed, operated by non-banking financial companies. White label ATMs means installed by, operated by non-banking financial companies. For starting off white label ATM, the NBFC minimum net worth required is 100 crores. 100 crores net worth. Now, what is market risk? Market risk related to investment prices. Market risk related to interest rate fluctuation. Market risk related to foreign currency fluctuation. So, in one word, market risk is equal to fluctuations in investment prices, fluctuation in interest rates, fluctuation in foreign currency. This is called credit risk. This is NPA risk or non-repayment risk in the advances. Banks are giving loans, NPA, because of NPA, banks are facing a lot of credit risk. That is there. Operation risk. Operation risk means risk of loss resulting from inadequate or failed internal processes. So, internal process failed or internal process not up to the mark. That is also. People, systems or people. People means frauds, non-compliances, systems failure, system hacking, or from external events are also resulting, risk of loss resulting from inadequate or failed internal process, people, system or others. So this is related to operations. As for Basel 2 and Basel 3, bank has to maintain capital for credit risk, market risk and operation risk. So the three types of risk are very, very important, and it is better to know by each participant what it is. P notes or participatory notes. These are the derivative instruments or contract notes issued by foreign institutional investors. Now, after taking registration with SEBI, foreign institutional investors, they are investing in India, in Indian stock market, on behalf of the investors situated abroad. Foreign institutional investors, after registration with SEBI, they are investing in Indian stock market on behalf of foreign investors who had not registered in India. So, again, foreign institutional investors are investing in India on behalf of the institutions residing, situated abroad, and in turn, they are issuing notes, participatory notes to investors by foreign institutional investors. But the foreign investors, they are not registering with SEBI. Who are registering with SEBI? Only foreign institutional investors. These foreign institutional investors are investing in India on behalf of various investors. And these foreign investors are not registered with SEBI. So, now foreign institution investors, they are investing in India on behalf of foreign investors. And again, in turn, foreign institutional investors, institutional investors are issuing participatory note to the original investors. This is called participatory notes. This is also allowed in hypothecation defined under SARFAESI Act 2000, so section 2, subsection N. Hypothecation, where it is defined? SARFAESI Act. Hypothecation becomes pledge when bank has taken the position from the customer. Hypothecation become pledge when bank has taken the position of the mobile goods from the customer. Ultra wires, beyond the powers of the company. Ultra means beyond the powers of the company. For ultra wires activities, company is not responsible. BCSBA, Banking Courts and Standard Board of India. This is customer service, related to customer service. Registered under Society Act. BCSBA was registered under Society Act. Based on Tarapur Committee recommendation. And this is a autonomous institution. This is a autonomous institution on various customer surveys, fair practices code. BCSBA is issuing guidelines. LTV, loan to value ratio, to be maintained for loan against jewelers, gold loans. Loan to value ratio to be maintained for loan against jewels. From 1st April 2021, that is 75%. Up to 31st March 2021, 90%. So, against loan to value ratio means against value of 100 rupees, now banks are permitted to give loan only 75. Then only 75 by 100, 75%. Because of last year COVID conditions, they had given up to 90% also, they are allowed to give finance. That is there. Now, presently 75%. Export credit is part of priority sector. Yes. Each account, each loan account up to 40 crores. If your banks are financing for export credit, that comes under priority sector export credit. Foreign banks operating in India with less than 20 branches, what is the priority sector target? For them also 40%. Out of which 40%, 32% they can give in exports and remaining 8% in other priority sector. Foreign banks with less than 20 branches, what is the priority sector target? 40%, out of which 32% in export sector and remaining 8% in other priority sector. Repairs to damaged dwelling units, housings, housing units. How much we can give under priority sector for repairs? Housing loan repair. 10 lakhs in metropolitan areas and other centers 6 lakhs. For housing loan repairs, 10 lakhs in metro, other areas 6 lakhs. Maximum education loan in India for priority sector, loan up to 20 lakhs we can give priority sector. Loan to startup, this is a new guideline as for last year priority sector guidelines. Up to 50 crores banks are allowed to finance under priority sector to startup units or organizations. This is also newly introduced thing. Who sets target for a priority sector? RBI, against banks, RBI. This is also last point. Co-lending means joint lending, jointly by banks and non-banking financial companies who are registered with RBI, jointly they can finance in priority sector. Co-lending jointly by banks and registered non-banking financial companies to in priority sector, yes. But one condition is there, NBFC share, out of total advance, NBFC minimum share is 20%. Whatever the loan they are giving jointly by banks and NBFCs, minimum amount of share, minimum amount of loan from NBFC is 20%. Remaining can be financed by the banks. This is also last year a little bit change. These questions are very useful for coming JAB principal and practice of. Thank you very much, viewers, for extending support to our YouTube channel. Thank you very much.